She wins some glasses and then she goes nuts.
All right, so the rain has arrived. Ridge is talking away quite happily, quite merrily. And what he's talking about is his favorite part of Chiku. Now, Chiku is the vehicle that we're in, and Brent's favorite part of Chiku is the windscreen wiper. As you can see, we only have one on one side, so if I wanted to look out of the windscreen, I can't.
I have to be cool.
And the fun part about Chiku's windscreen wiper is that it often doesn't stay on unless you hold the switch up. So Brent has to time it by flicking it.
Which and also the squeak.
Squeak, 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 squeak.
We also just had to try and get my passenger window up. And this is the handle to the passenger window. And this is a Leatherman, and that's what we used. Now, James, you want to know the rainy season in the Mara, when it is. There's actually two. There's the sort of the main big rains, which technically should end around now. Actually should have ended around May. So they go from around about the beginning of year, hit their peak in March, April. Uh-oh, man on a motorbike. Two men on a motorbike. In the mud. Oh, careful, careful.
Hola, buena, Mari. Bombo.
And then after that they have their dry season. Sorry, James, got distracted by the motorbikes that are basically used as private transport.
Taxis.
It's taxis. They're a taxi. And then you have the small rains. Is that what they call them? The small rains. In November. That come as a huge relief, I think, to all of the people and the animals here, as they come right at the sort of the end of the dry season. So they get a little bit of rain there. Helps make everything nice and green once again.
I'm very happy with myself.
You're very happy with yourself?
I managed to switch it off at the right time.
Oh, well done. Has it stopped raining? No, it's just the calm before the storm.
Flirting around the edge of the main rain at the moment.
Flirting around the edge of the rain. Right, well, we're going to have to go straight through the rain.
We are, unfortunately. So it looks like we're going to have to cross the Mara River in a little bit. Once we pass the village of Mara Rianta. And once we're through Mara Rianta, we go across the low water bridge. Across the Mara River. You got to be quite careful about that bridge because the Mara River comes from the Mao Highlands, and if the Mao Highlands get a lot of rain and flood, we have to sleep on this side. And the guest houses are interesting.
Yes, let's put it that way. Interesting. Alice, sorry, you just said something to me and I have no idea what it was.
Ooh, slippery. Yay, we are driving sideways now, guys. So important ever to hit the brakes when you're in the mud, because as soon as you hit the brakes, you lock it and you can slide the vehicle all the way. But if you're driven in mud or snow, actually, it's quite similar. It's quite fun.
Oh, I have a terrifying suspicion that I'm going to be the next person to get stuck, because I have not driven in the mud since I came to Djuma, basically. You don't really drive in the mud in Djuma, not all that often. The biggest chance you have of getting stuck at Djuma is an arc bark hole. But out here, the road is slowly but surely washing away. This is a very exciting journey. I've actually completely forgotten where we are. What's the gate called?
We went to Musiara again.
Musiara, and that's the one that there's a cheetah named Musiara.
Yes. Musiara had five cubs when I arrived. We saw them from a distance the one day, and she now has one cub. Very difficult for a cheetah to raise cubs in this area. So many lions, so many hyenas.
Shame. I have to say, in this confined space, usually we have the windows open and we have the roof open. I have to say, it's now it's gone from quite chilly to now stuffy, substantially stuffy. Stand on our seats in order to talk to you through the roof.